Hi everyone and welcome back. Welcome to my playlist where I was covering React with TypeScript and React testing. So we already have covered both these playlists in a separate videos. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to cover some full stack apps which will be built with React and TypeScript, and we will also add the test cases for mocking the API calls, for testing the components using React testing library. Okay, so what we are going to do is either we can use the sandbox. This can be helpful like to create any kind of application, either React, React TypeScript, or any kind of application. Right, so what we are going to do is we can use simple React. So there are a couple of applications which I'm going to cover in React, vanilla React, and then some applications I'm going to cover in React TypeScript, and also we will add the test cases for that. So you can use sandbox or you can use the local setup. I'm not going to explain the setup because it's all create React app. It's just like in the when we are talking about the TypeScript, you have to add the type definitions for the React, React DOM. So I'm just explaining about the process, like how can you create a create React app with the TypeScript. So here you can see npx create React app, your application name, and the template can be your TypeScript. So just like a random medium block I picked up instead of doing all these things, and this will give you the create React app with the TypeScript flavor and all the files. You see, this is the content you are going to get, and all the files will be TSX, right? This is the default syntax. And if you just see, if you want to convert an existing project into a TypeScript project, what you need to do is you just need to add the type definitions. Type definitions for React, type definitions for React DOM, and for the Jest. And convert JS to the TSX files and add the tsconfig in your app. This is a simple tsconfig app you need to add, right? And then you are good to go. So this is how you can actually get started with React TypeScript. If you wanted to build something from scratch, you can use create React app and pass the template as a TypeScript, and you will get the folder, right? You don't need to like just run this command and just check this. If you just give it a want, then what you can do is you can run this particular command and you can just check what will be the output. Okay, we will just go through the folder structure and the content, like what all it is generating. You can see it is now installing all the dependencies for us. So it is creating the TypeScript template, create React app template TypeScript. It is using React script and the primary packages React and React DOM. On top of that, it will be adding the TypeScript type definitions for the React, React DOM, and the Jest, because it is the whole setup where you can do npm run start, npm run build, npm run test. You should be able to write the test cases using React testing library, and it is going to use latest React version. So now we have these kind of tools like create React app, Angular CLI, Vue CLI. I mean, every framework or library kind of have a CLI tool to build the application quickly. You don't need to struggle with the configurations. So similarly, like earlier, we used to write a lot of Webpack configurations and all to create a simple React application with the Babel. Right now, you don't need to do anything. It's just like create React app, and it will give you the TypeScript template, or if you want a simple JavaScript template with the ES6, that also you will receive. Now these are all are the dependencies you can see: React Dev Utils, React DOM, React Script, React, and it is using 16.0.2. Always also check that what version you are familiar with. Are you familiar with the latest concepts? Then you can use the latest concepts, like the context APIs, all different set of folks, all different new things which are coming up with the React version. And it is taking some time. We can just wait until this is done, and then we will just take a look on to the folder structure, how that looks like, and then we will go from there. So these are test dependencies, like testing library user events, testing library DOM, testing library React testing library. These are like dev dependencies which we need for defining the tests. Here you can see all the dependencies: testing library DOM, testing library Jest DOM, testing library React. All these four modules are used for writing the unit test cases using React testing library. Earlier we used to do Enzyme and all those different libraries, Enzyme with adapters. Now it's very clean. You can just import testing library React, testing library DOM, testing library user event, and you get everything from that. Okay. And here we will see what we received. Okay. If we go inside SRC, now you can see the files are with the TSX, right? All the files are having TSX syntax. index.tsx, even there is a test case is also created. Let's go outside and you can also take a look on tsconfig, because that is a compiler configuration. This is telling your compiler, okay, this is the React code and compiled it into with these all kind of rules. So target is ES5 2015. Okay, ES5 is the target for compiler, and all these libraries it is using, DOM iterables and all. And we have to include the source folder, and these are all our TypeScript compiler options like skiplib, check, esmodule, interop, strict. All these has their own specific meaning when the TypeScript is being compiled by the compiler. Okay, so this is the tsconfig, and whenever you do npm run build, what it is doing, it is compiling, it is building your code with this TypeScript compiler, and it is giving you the ES5 target output inside build.dist folder. It is creating the optimized production build. It is using the all webpack stuff, you can see, and it will create a optimized production build. When you do npm run start, it will actually use the webpack dev server underlying, and it will start your application on port 3000. And when you do npm run test, it will again like run the test cases for your application. Okay, your TypeScript version is this. Yes, so this is like there is a conflict, right, in the TypeScript versions. So what you can do, I think my VS Code TypeScript version is 4.4.3, or my Workspace TypeScript version is this. So either you can bring it down or you can upgrade, because currently we are using the latest version of React script, and that is supporting only this, so you can downgrade that. And this is the build is successful. You can do npm run test. Hopefully if there is a test, it will run those tests with the help of jest. Jest is like underlying structure. It is using this React script is using jest as a runner, and React testing library to write the component test cases. Okay, I think we don't have test cases. And then we can do npm run start. Npm run start, what it does is it spin up your application on port 3000, and it will host your application there on HTTP server running on port 3000. That is nothing but that is a webpack dev server. Okay, so this is just an overview, and what I'm going to do from here is I will start the React TypeScript projects, some kind of a clone. Okay, there we will understand how to define the TypeScript typings, and also how we can write the test cases using React testing library. Okay, so that's it. This is just introductory that what I'm going to cover in the coming videos. I'm merging these both the playlists, React with TypeScript and React with the testing, using React testing library.